Are you familiar, I'm sure you are, with something that's often referred to as the Access Hollywood tape?
Yes, I am.
Okay, let's play. Let's mark it and play it as what, 35.
You know, and
she used to be great. She's still very beautiful.
I moved on her, actually. You know, she was down in Palm Beach. I moved on her, and I failed. I'll admit it.
Whoa.
I did try and f*** her. She was married.
That's huge news there.
No, Nancy. Yeah. No, this was marriages. And I moved on her very heavily. In fact, I took her out furniture shopping. She wanted to get some furniture. I said, I'll show you where they have some nice furniture. I took her out furniture. I moved on her like a b***h, but I couldn't get there. And she was married. And all of a sudden, I see her. She's now got the big phony tits and everything. She's totally changed her look.
She's your girl's hottest in the purple.
Whoa.
Yes.
Whoa.
Yes, the Donald has scored.
Whoa.
Oh, my man. Wait, you got to look at me when you get out.
Remember who sets this up.
That is very
funny. Will you give me the
thumbs
up?
Look at you. You are a
You got to get the thumbs up. Can't be too happy.
Can anybody else off first? Yeah, let me.
It's very funny.
You got to give me the thumbs up.
You and I will love that.
So can I have it open? Can you have it open?
Oh, my God.
Can I have it closed?
Maybe it's a different one.
Better not be the publicist. No, it's her. It's
yeah, that's her, with the gold. I better use some Tic Tacs just in case I start kissing her. You know, I'm automatically attracted to beautiful. I just start kissing them. It's like a magnet. You just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab them by the I can do anything.
Look at those legs. All I can see is the legs.
No, it looks good.
Come on, shorty.
Oh, nice legs, huh?
Oof. Get out of the way, honey. That's good legs. Go ahead.
It's always good if you don't fall out of the bus. Like Ford, Gerald Ford, remember?
Down below. Pull the hell.
Hello, how are you? Hi.
Mr. Trump, how
nice
are
seeing you? Terrific.
Pleasure to meet you.
Terrific. You know Billy Bush?
Hello, how are
nice
you?
To see you. How are you doing, Ariane?
I'm doing very well, thank you. Are you ready to be a soap star?
We're ready. Let's go. Make right. me a soap star.
How about absolutely. A little hug for the Donnelly? Just got off the bus.
Like a little
okay,
hug,
absolutely. Melania said this was okay.
That's you in that video, correct?
Yes. Okay. And you know what I said then, and I say it now? Locker room talk. That was locker room talk.
Okay.
That's what goes on.
And you did say in the video that you, quote, moved on her heavily, correct?
Excuse me?
You do say in the video that you, quote,
yeah.
moved on her heavily.
I did say that, yes, okay. absolutely.
And you do say in the video that as part of trying to have sex with this woman, you took her furniture shopping, correct?
We actually did look for furniture, yes.
So that was true. You actually took this woman
in. I think so. I mean, it's been a long time ago. It's how long is it? Long time ago, but I think so. I do think so.
Is that the only occasion when you took a woman shopping?
I think so.
And you say, and again, this has become very famous in this video, I just start kissing them. It's like a magnet. Just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything. Grab them by the you can do anything. That's what you said, correct?
Well, historically, that's true with stars.
True with stars that they can grab women by the
that's what it's if you look over the last million years, I guess that's been largely true, not always, but largely true, unfortunately or fortunately.
And you consider yourself to be a star?
I think you can say that, yeah.
And now you said before a couple of minutes ago that this was just locker room talk.
It's locker room talk.
And so does that mean that you didn't really mean it?
No, it's locker room talk. I don't know. It's just the way people talk.
Did you or anyone on your staff reach out to anyone at Bergdorf Goodman?
I didn't have to reach out to anybody because it didn't happen. And by the way, if it did happen, it would have been reported within minutes. Talking about going to a major floor, probably, I assume, the most important floor. A major floor in a major department store that's a very busy store, by the way, and checkout counters and everything else. And I would be in there. I mean, it's the most ridiculous, disgusting story. It was just made up.
After you made the statements that you made in June of 2019, did you or anyone working for you reach out to Bergdorf Goodman?
After the statement was made, no.
In your June 21 statement that's marked as Exhibit 20, you say, and this is the Litvin tweet, I never met this person in my life.
Yes.
In front of you, a black and white photograph that we've marked as DJT 23. And I'm going to ask you, is this the photo that you were just referring to?
I think so, yes.
Okay. And do you recall when you first saw this photo?
At some point during the process, I saw it. That's, I guess, her husband, John Johnson, who was an anchor for ABC. Nice guy. I thought, I mean, I don't know him, but I thought he was pretty good at what he did. I don't even know who the woman. Let's see. I don't know who. It's Marla.
You're saying Marla's in this photo?
That's Marla, yeah. That's my wife.
Which woman are you pointing to?
No.
That's here.
Carol.
Oh, is that?
The person
okay.
You just pointed to was E. Jean Carroll.
Who is that? Who is this?
Point, your wife.
And the person, the woman on the right is your then wife,
I don't know. This was the picture. Ivana. I assume that's John Johnson. Is that
that's Carol?
Because it's very blurry.
What you said there is, I'll say it with great respect, number one, she's not my type. When you said that Ms. Carroll was not your type, you meant that she was not your type physically, right?
I saw her in a picture. I didn't know what she looked like. And I said it, and I say it with as much respect as I can, but she is not my type.
And again, when you say type, you just refer to looking at photos, so you mean physically she's not your type?
Physically she's not my type, and now that I've gotten indirectly to hear things about her, she wouldn't be my type in any way, shape, or form.
But when you were talking back on June 24th, you were referring to her not being your type physically,
correct? I saw a photo of her.
Okay.
And the only difference between me and other people is I'm honest. She's not my type.
I think you said a few minutes earlier that you used the word swooned as a synonym for, you said the F word, for sexual intercourse?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's because that's what she said.
What do you mean? She never used the word swooned.
No. She said that I did something to her that never took place. There was no anything. I know nothing about this nut job.
Okay, then you go on to say in the statement, and while I am not supposed to say it, I will. Why were you not supposed to say it?
Because it's not politically correct to say, read the next, go ahead, that she's not my type. Yeah, because it's not politically correct to say it, and I know that, but I'll say it anyway. She's accusing me of rape. A woman that I have no idea who she is. It came out of the blue. She's accusing me of rape. Of raping her. The worst thing you can do, the worst charge. And you know it's not true too. You're a political operative also. You're a disgrace. But she's accusing me, and so are you, of rape, and it never took place. And I will tell you, I made that statement and I said, well, it's politically incorrect, she's not my type. And that's 100% true. She's not my type.